GRF as an organization is unique because it's the largest foundation in the country, maybe in the world, focused only on one disease, glaucoma. And we've recognized that glaucoma is a disease of elevated pressure in the eye, but it also affects the optic nerve in ways we don't understand. Sometimes you lower pressure and it stops the disease. Sometimes it doesn't. And in those cases, we think there's a neurodegenerative portion for the disease. We focused in that area and now are working very hard at trying to recognize the early signs of glaucoma so that we can accelerate the development of treatments.
Glaucoma is a really tough disease. Worldwide, glaucoma is the leading cause of blindness, other than cataracts. And the big problem worldwide is we don't have a good way to diagnose the disease. We need better biomarkers, in other words. We have no way for patients who have lost vision in glaucoma to restore that vision, to give them back vision that we've lost. Right now, all of our treatments, the best that they can do is try to slow the decline or prevent the further loss of vision.
The Catalyst for a Cure consortium is unique in that it involves four different laboratories, each of which is involved in trying to understand a different aspect of detecting, monitoring, and treating glaucoma. And this is unusual in that typically labs are funded independently to work on projects separate from one another, and they might share their results or talk about the results with one another at a meeting or after publication. But the whole basis of Catalyst for a Cure is that we actively collaborate at every stage of the projects in order to make more rapid and long-standing progress.
What's unique about this collaboration is that we're funded to collaborate. We can share ideas as they're obtained immediately. And so if I have a great idea of a new way to measure blood flow in the retina and we implement it in our lab, I can send that immediately over to Alf and he can build on it in his lab and accelerate progress and achieve the end goal faster so that Alf doesn't have to wait until the results are published to pursue them in his lab.
One of the things that is really powerful about the approach that we are pursuing is that we are borrowing ideas from astronomy, microscopy, mathematics, and chemistry even, and then trying to combine them so that, and adapt them so that they can be used to study disease in vivo.
Glaucoma is very difficult to detect and treat for a couple reasons. One is that the cells that are affected, retinal ganglion cells, are optically clear, and this is very important. Nature designed the eye in a way so that light can pass through the ganglion cells and into the photoreceptors, which are the light detecting cells within the retina. But because they're clear, it's impossible to focus an image onto the ganglion cells and to essentially look at the ganglion cells and see how many they are and evaluate whether or not they're healthy or not. So what we're trying to do is develop biomarkers that would enable us to see those cells in really sharp relief and be able to interrogate those cells and ask whether or not they're in a healthy, sick, or perhaps getting sick state.
One important finding from Andrew Huberman's lab at the University of California, San Diego, is that connections in a specific layer of the retina change first in early glaucoma. And we believe that this particular layer of the retina may provide us with a biomarker for early changes in glaucoma.
A central portion of this search for biomarkers is to develop tools that are not available currently. And one of the techniques that was the most exciting developments in the last year, not only for glaucoma, but actually for the whole of vision, the vision community, is the development of the split detection technique. There are two key innovations here in this device, and one of them is a little mask over here that actually, rather than just collecting the light through a central small pinhole, is actually letting all the light around that pinhole, rather than be wasted, is collected here in the back by two light detectors. And by combining those two, we've been able to create images with unprecedented contrast of things that are transparent inside the retina. And that really has been probably one of the most exciting optical innovations in the field. And it is what is allowing us to see the vasculature And we're hoping that we can continue to improve on this technique to hopefully one day reveal the retinal ganglion cells non-invasively.
I'd like to thank the friends, donors, and supporters of the Glaucoma Research Foundation, Catalyst for a Cure, for their support. I believe that the momentum that this team has built over the past 3 years, the expertise we've developed in glaucoma, and the ideas we've identified for earlier detection, better diagnosis and management and treatment of the disease are all very exciting. And I think that over the next 3 years, we have a real potential to have a significant impact in how this disease is managed and treated.